So, Toni Morrison talks about this idea of the flood, that, human beings look at something and say, that's a flood, but it's rarely actually a flood. We take a river that knows where it's supposed to be, and we try to push it somewhere else, but water knows where it comes from, and water knows where it's supposed to be, and the water finds its way back, and it's inconvenient when it does. And so we call it a flood. And so she says, this is what the writer does. We flood back to that origin point and we feel it run across our skin and we can't
Wow.
escape it. And I think she's totally right. And
Yes.
my primal flood was this experience in my life of us being so poor that we had to leave our trailer and go live with an aunt and uncle, an abusive uncle, who threw away the one gift I was able to get for Christmas. And I feel like 90% of the time that I'm writing, I'm trying to process what happened in that moment of being so totally powerless. And I tried to write this poem. I actually, once I knew I was writing a collection, said, okay, this has to be in there. And I couldn't write it at
Wow.
all. So
Interesting.
I ended up sending this whole collection that was meant to be about that poem without it being
Right.
in there. And so Ada Limon came to Mount Sterling. And I was in the audience and I asked her this question, what do you do when your flood wants to go there and you can't touch it? Her answer was very, very nuanced. But one of the things that she said was, maybe the flood's too dangerous to stand in, sort of. Can you stand nearby? Can you pick something that was in that moment with you and write about it instead? And so I had tried to write this from my perspective. And I'm not saying that I wrote it from this bear's perspective, but I thought I'm just going to write about the bear itself. That was the way that I could do this.
Right. What an incredible writing assignment for a student who is struggling with a trauma or a pain. You don't have to stand in the flood and face the oncoming waters. You can just stand on the bank.